Please welcome the Chief Executive Officer, Opel Vauxhall, Nick Reilly.
Good morning, everybody. It's a pleasure to see you all here again at the Geneva Motor Show, and welcome. I'd like to welcome all of the media, also the Opel Vauxhall Leadership Board, and Klaus Franz, who's the head of our Works Council. Welcome, everybody. I'm sorry we're starting a couple of minutes late, but apparently the whole show is running late. Some of our competitors obviously had too much to say. Now, before I share some exciting Opel Vauxhall news, I have two very special guests I'd like to introduce. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our EcoFlex and Ampera ambassador, Katie Melua. Katie, welcome to the Geneva Motor Show. You were going at such speed there, I wasn't sure you were going to stop, but that's great.
I love it, it drives pretty fast.
It's good, yeah, it does. Well, welcome again. It's a pleasure to have you here. Now, as you know, this car is very green, and you've been involved with the environmental work for quite some time, haven't you? Would you like to tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, to me, the environment matters a lot. And I think, you know, the planet is the most precious thing we have, and I try and take care of it as much as I can. I do a little bit like gardening and, you know, try and conserve water and electricity as much as I can. So.
You're involved in our Project Earth as well, right?
Yes, Project Earth, definitely. It's very exciting.
Well, such an extraordinary green project is a perfect fit for a revolutionary car like the Ampera. And I understand you drove in with another special guest.
I did indeed. I'd love to introduce Dan Akerson.
So, ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to GM Chairman and CEO, Mr. Dan Akerson. Dan, welcome to your first Geneva show. And it'd be great if you could share some of your thoughts about GM generally and about your first trip to the Geneva show in Europe. Dan, over to you.
Thanks, Nick. Thanks, Katie. I appreciated the ride. It was a thrill for me. I don't know about you. In short, GM is committed to its operations in Europe, to the Opel brand, to Opel employees, and most importantly, to the current and future Opel customers. Opel Vauxhall restructuring is on track, and I'm confident that our European team will achieve its stated goals for 2011. To talk more about how we'll achieve that success, let me hand it back to Nick. Thank you very much.
Nick. Thanks, Nick. Well, thank you, Dan. And indeed, we have made some good progress over the past year. To fully charge the Ampera can cost as little as €1. That's enough charge to drive 60 kilometers. In other words, we're talking about an energy cost of less than €2 for 100 kilometers. Imagine what this means to those people who will be driving the Ampera mostly in electric mode. I'm also pleased to announce today that the Ampera will be covered by the lifetime warranty in those countries where Opel and Vauxhall offer it. Plus, we're offering around Europe an 8-year, 160,000 kilometer warranty for the Ampera's battery system. But apart from our visions of electric and urban mobility, we're also presenting you our vision of how to take interior flexibility a step further with the Zafira Tourer concept. The design department is under the leadership of our Vice President of Design, Mark Adams. And Mark, I'd like to invite you now to join me on stage and tell us more about the beautiful concept car.
stunning Arctic landscape have to do with Opel and why the igloo? Well, in short, the answer is that designers get their inspiration from the most unexpected sources. And with our new Opel concept car, it sprang from the idea of a refuge, which provides warmth, comfort, and a feeling of wellness while protecting you against nature's harshest elements. The exterior of this igloo is sculpted, smooth, solid, and impervious to the bitter cold, just like our concept. Much like a blanket of liquid metal which enhances the comfort within, the interior is warm, spacious, and inviting. Let me show you what I mean. There you go, that's much better. I can actually see you now. So now I'm inside where it's warm, let me describe our approach to this interior. As you can see, it's very bright and airy. The whole interior has been crafted with the highest quality materials, which creates a design that is both spacious and sophisticated. And to ensure great views and a feeling of openness, we've provided this panoramic roof, which is elegant in its simplicity. But most important, it's a space where you can relax, alone with your thoughts, or in a conversation with friends. A flexible hideaway to recharge, reconnect, or simply lounge. In fact, this concept is a lounge on wheels. It's more than a concept. It's our vision of elevating Zafira's legendary flexibility to new heights. Introducing the new Zafira Tourer Concept. Design details, so let me start at the very front of the vehicle here. As you can see, it's really inspired like a bullet train, has a very dynamic piercing nose with these boomerang type headlamps with the typical Opel wing signature lighting. As you move down the vehicle, has a very flowing shape, very dynamic, and lots of sculptural beauty in the surfacing itself. But on this vehicle, it's on the inside that counts. And as you would expect, anything with a Zafira name has to have 7 seats. But the beauty with this vehicle is you can move from 7, 5 to 4 seating in what we call lounge mode to create a very spacious, open environment that is very, very high quality and has a great premium feel. But you know, I can talk about design for hours, but I'm going to stop right here. I can talk to some of you later. And I'm going to hand it back to Nick. Thank you.
Thanks, Mark. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, we are progressing in a lot of different ways. We've got a tremendously exciting array of products around and innovations being developed this year. We'll continue to pursue our goals of environmentally friendly, sustainable mobility. And it's under this umbrella that we will bring the Ampera to market at the end of this year. And you can expect more to come from Opel. So now I'd like to invite you to come up on the stage and the Opel Vauxhall leadership too as well, and thank Dan and Katie once again for joining us today. Thank you all very much.